Hi, my name's Craig, and welcome to the Wizard Product Review. I know you don't want to do a show this week, but I thought you might want to explain to everybody why not. I know you've had a busy week, so I'll set the camera up. I thought you could say hello to everybody.
Here, we haven't got time. We're not doing the Wizard Product Review this week.
Why don't you just tell everybody what's going on?
Oh, that's very nice of you, actually. Yeah, okay. Craig's given me the opportunity to just say thanks for all the messages on the Magic Cafe and on Facebook.
Because everyone's been really
supportive. Britain's Got Talent.
I know you have, but just one sec. Have you seen this?
I've got to rehearse an illusion, Craig.
Just came in, The Gambler.
Right.
By some French guy, Julien. Come on, help me out here. What's this, do you reckon?
Labigny?
I know, it's some French guy. It came into the review pile.
The Gambler.
Yeah, The Gambler. And I thought, before you shoot off, I could just quickly tell you about it. Yeah. I know you're busy.
I've got to rehearse an illusion.
I know you have.
Okay.
Just two minutes.
Yeah.
Guaranteed, 2 minutes. It's an interesting premise.
Right, okay.
Have you seen the trailer?
What happens?
Well, basically, what he does is, I've actually got the box of stuff here. He brings out a box like this.
Yeah.
Okay? And he puts it down and he brings out a whole bunch of props. He brings out a pack of cards and he brings out a couple of casino chips.
Yeah.
And he brings out a dice and he brings out a matchbox. And he talks about how this is a gambler's kit.
Right, yeah.
And what he does,
I've not seen this because I've been busy.
I know, it's really good. Because what happens is he brings out this gambler's kit and there's this whole story about how he's into gambling. And the matchbox is kind of a...
I saw this on the trailer, actually. I remember thinking, like, why has he got a matchbox?
It's
a good luck charm.
Yeah, he calls it a good luck charm, like gamblers.
Didn't really make any sense.
No. It's French, so he actually says, I have a whole bunch of stuff in here and I am going to take them out one at a time and show you. And what happens is they choose a poker chip.
50-50.
Yeah, 50-50. Yeah. They choose a number and a dice.
Right.
And they choose a playing card.
Yeah.
And then, at the end of the routine, he shows that he's predicted the card, the number on the dice, and the poker chip.
That's pretty good. That sounds pretty good, actually. When I saw it on the video, I remember thinking there's a lot of stuff there to carry, but it looked like it was self-working, quite easy to do.
Well, it is self-working. It is self-working, and there's three different principles at play. I've got a couple of issues with it. My first issue is, one, it's kind of a big box to carry around.
Right.
You know, it's kind of, you've got to carry this.
Yeah, yeah, it doesn't look great either.
But then, in order to do it just like he does it, you've got to lay stuff out all over the table. Like you've got to lay the cards out. It's a special pack of cards.
It's quite a nice story, though, isn't it? You know, getting them to change things.
It is an interesting story.
It is self-working.
It is self-working.
And there's lots of choices, you know, not
there,
just
there
like,
are lots of choices, because
you know,
they're choosing this,
and that
they're choosing
kind of
that. The problem with it is, you've got to use this pack of cards for it's a special pack of cards,
right? Okay,
and you can only use it for this one trick,
okay?
And it uses, at its heart, one of the main principles it uses is a principle that we looked at the Legacy,
yes,
a couple of weeks ago. And the problem
but that was only a fan of cards, wasn't
that
it?
That was only a fan of cards. And he's using a similar principle in this, but the problem is I don't think how he uses that principle is as clever as the Legacy was. You know, like with the Legacy, everything was, I'm trying not to give anything away, but remember everything was inside the wallet?
Yes, yeah.
With this, the reason he's got a matchbox.
And you've got the box.
And the box and the lid to the box and the pack of cards. There's a whole bunch of different things in there. And I just don't think... For the effect,
if you were going to review that, what would you give this? As
well, you
a
know,
mark?
For the, I can see it working for some people.
Yeah.
For amateurs and hobbyists, I think it'd be great because it's really easy to do. You can do it straight away, and it's not a problem for them to take a box around. For a pro, I think carrying a big box like this and then
it's got its problems.
You need
it?
All
yeah.
the table in order to do it. I think it's a little bit too much for the effect.
I watched the video, the dem. The good thing is it's self-working. There's lots of possibility. I think if I was going to mark this, you know, it's difficult to mark it. I'd probably give it sort of 54%, something like
that.
Yeah,
I don't think I could give it more than 60%, 65%. It's okay. I mean, the idea is if it's the sort of thing that you might think, hey, I'd like to perform that, then it's an okay trick. The premise behind it is really good.
Yeah, if you're a hobbyist and you're not too concerned about pocket space carrying all this stuff.
But as you always say on the show, when we do a show, as you always say, you've only got a certain amount of time to do material. You know, you want to do your best stuff.
Well, that's great. Thanks for showing me that. And thanks again for all the good messages on the Magic Cafe.
No, sit back down. Sit back down for a minute. Sit back down. I just want to ask you one more thing.
Right.
One more thing. Have you ever heard of?
I've actually got to go.
Yeah. I totally get that. I really know, and I'm bet Karen busy and everything. But have you ever heard of a guy called
semi-finals this week?
I know, but have you ever heard of a guy called John Kerry?
I have heard of him.
You must have seen him around. He's a really clever target.
Yeah.
Well, this is his
I've been
new
meaning
DVD.
To watch this DVD. Is it any good?
Well, he gave it us for review when we went to the Bristol convention. And right. I know you weren't there because you were busy with Britain's Got Talent.
Yeah.
But he gave it to me.
Right, okay.
And I've had a chance to watch it.
Yeah.
And I know that you wanted to watch it. So I thought I'd just quickly tell you about it.
I can't watch it
now. I know you're busy, but I've only... 2 minutes.
Okay, right.
I want to tell you about it, but there's actually a trick in there that's really good. I think you really like it.
Can you do it?
Yeah, I can. I opened it up half an hour ago. I can do it already. I really can.
You can do it already?
Yeah.
That's
do you want to
good.
See it really quickly?
Yeah, come on then.
Yeah,
right.
I've got a pack of cards.
We can do that.
You can do that? You know Do As I Do? You know the kind of the Do As I Do
yes.
trick?
Yeah.
It's got a really nice one deck version called, I think it's something like Do Belducci As I Belducci or something like that. Here we go. Well, I'll show it you anyway. It's I don't know where it is on there. It's a regular pack of cards. Most of his stuff is a regular pack.
Right, okay.
So there's like no gimmicks, no extras. And I know that you've always wanted to be a magician.
I have, actually.
Yeah. I saw the picture of you on the internet when you were like 7 years
old. I know,
I
want it desperately.
So I'm going to give you a chance to learn how to be a card magician, okay?
Right, yeah.
Now, the first thing card magicians do is they shuffle the cards. So you give the cards a shuffle for me.
Right. You can just put that there.
It's a bit rude, isn't it? Kind of a little bit weird, but there you go.
Right.
And then when you shuffle the cards, the next thing you've got to do if you're going to do a card trick is you spread the cards out and you say to me in your best magician's voice, pick a card, any card.
Pick a card, any card.
I'm going to go for that one.
Right.
Now you tell me to remember the card.
Right, remember the card.
Got it.
Yeah.
And you tell me to put it back in the pack.
Put it back in the pack.
Okay. And
anywhere?
You would... Yeah. Anyway, and you'd then shuffle the cards again.
Right.
Okay. Now, I'm going to do the same thing, because yeah, it's pretty fair, isn't it? Right?
Yeah.
I'm going to do the same thing as well, so I'll give the cards a quick shuffle, okay? And I'm going to get you to pick a card, so any card.
Right.
Okay, remember it, don't forget it.
Do I show the camera?
If you want to. I didn't bother, but you can do if you want to. Put the card back. Okay, now this is the idea here, Dave. I've got to shuffle the cards as well, actually, haven't I? Give them a bit of a mix-up like this, just like you did. Now, the idea is I have to try and find your card, and you have to find my card.
Right, okay.
Okay, now I'm going to show you how a good magician finds a card.
Okay.
They can cut to it within two cuts. Okay, so I'm going to try and cut to your card within two cuts. Let me see. That's one cut. Notice I turn the cards over, and then I cut a little bit deeper, and I do my second cut.
Yeah.
And I've cut to one random face-down card, which I'm going to put right there. Now, you try and do the same thing. So what I'm going to do is cut a packet of cards off, turn them face up,
yeah,
and then cut deeper. Cut more cards, and turn them face up, yeah, and spread through for the first face-down card. And put it there.
Got it.
Okay, cool. So think about it for a minute. You can hold on to the rest of the cards. Think about it for a minute. You picked a card.
Yeah.
I picked a card. Shuffled into the pack.
That was
totally
fair.
Now, as a magician, you know, I do magic. It's expected that I should find your card. And I managed to cut to the Queen of Clubs. Was that your card?
It was a card, yeah.
But if you managed to get my card, that'd be even more amazing.
That's amazing.
I picked the Seven of Spades. Have a look, see if you got it.
Seven of Spades.
There you go. Isn't that nice?
That's a good trick.
And you know
I like
what?
That.
It's a shuffled deck in use. But the reason I wanted to show you that is because that kind of typifies John's thinking behind his magic.
That's very good.
It's very simple. I mean, you obviously aren't fooled by that.
What,
you know how
what,
it works.
What else is on the DVD? What sort of material?
Really cool stuff. Okay. It's not all cards. I thought it was going to be all cards because John Kerry is known as a card guy.
Yeah, yeah.
It's not all cards. Triple impersonation is like a spellbound routine.
Right.
Really nice. You bring a coin out of a purse, it changes copper, silver, brass, changes back to copper, changes back to silver, and eventually it vanishes and all the coins are back in the purse the spectator's been holding on to.
Cool.
That was really nice.
Would you recommend this DVD?
Yeah, there is some routines that I wasn't actually too keen on. For example, I don't think he does a one coin routine. I think it's called GYS coin or something like that. It's a one coin routine, a bit like
right,
Roth's
okay.
Flurry. It's not that good. It doesn't really add anything to the plot. But some of the stuff, pocket interchange, absolutely fantastic. The Do As I Do that you just saw, really, really good. Gemini detector, very, very good. And what's nice about it, Dave, he's got a toolbox section where he goes through a whole bunch of different slides.
All the moves you
so
name.
So he teaches you the spread double, the optical reverse, full shuffle, all stuff like that.
And obviously it's RSVP magic.
And you know what's nice? All of the routines are performed live.
That's good.
In Illusions.
Excellent.
All to real people. And he's got Ian Moran and Sean McCree sitting in with him with the explanation. So the Sean's great, well. And Ian Moran is probably my favourite magician of all time. So it's really well explained.
That's great.
What
would you give it as a percentage?
You know, if we were doing a show this week,
yeah,
I'd probably say this was Worker of the Week. If we were doing a show,
I'd probably give that.
That's fair enough. I know you haven't, but
and a percentage?
I'd say 92%. If you're a worker, there's some great stuff in this. But if you're an amateur, it worked really well as well. I really like this DVD.
That's great. Right, brilliant. Cool. Fantastic. That's great.
Actually, Dave, before you go, one more thing. I know you've got to go. You look really lovely. Okay. To go, but just sit down for one last thing. Because there's one other thing I want to show you.
Right, okay.
Very, very quickly. Because I think you could use this on Britain's Got Talent.
Is it that good?
It's that good. I think
if I get into the final, I've got some real pressure. That's why I've got to go, because I've got some pressure.
Think about it. I mean, I saw the audition piece. It was fantastic.
Yeah.
And if you get into the final, I think you should do this.
Seriously. Is it that good? It
really is that good. So take 2 minutes, because this could be something that you could seriously consider for the final.
Okay, yeah. Okay. Right. I've always listened to you.
Now, it's a coin routine. Because I think, you know, you kind of done the big
Amanda
box.
Amanda Holden doesn't like
I know, no, no,
magic.
But think about it. You've done the she big boxes and stuff, and you've done the thing, and you could surprise them by coming straight in with a coin trick. They wouldn't see that. You could get a little table out, and you could get all the judges on the stage around the table.
What would Karen do?
She could, like, stand there and point and stuff, maybe. No, she wouldn't like that.
If she ever heard you say that, she'd be pretty upset.
Luckily, this is never going out.
No, it's no, okay.
Well, let me show you. Well, maybe Karen could do it, and you could stand and point, maybe.
Yeah, maybe. Okay, well, let me show you. Have to rehearse it, then. That'd
well,
be good.
What it is it's a routine that Dr. Michael Rubenstein...
You like him, don't you?
I think he's a fantastic magician.
Right, okay.
He pioneered coin magic with, you know, him and David Roth and Jeff Latter, you know, the late
right,
and,
okay.
And Mike Gallo. Those guys have pioneered coin magic. And basically, what it is, what I like about it... Okay, there's some... I think that this routine, some people, you're either going to like it or hate it. It's going to be a little
right,
bit
okay.
like Marmite. And
can you do any of it? Can you explain the premise of it?
The premise behind it. Yeah, basically what happens is, let's say I borrowed a 10p off you.
Yeah, yeah.
And I pointed out the picture of the Queen.
Right.
And I said, she's not looking very happy.
Okay.
And I drew a little smiley face, an unhappy smiley face, like
right,
a frowny
okay.
face
yeah,
on
yeah.
there with a Sharpie marker. And then it really looks this clean. All you do is you take the coin and you rub it.
Yeah.
And the smile turns upside down. The frown turns upside down. So the ink on it is now smiling.
Oh, right. Okay.
Which is a nice little plot. It's kind of like a spell band. But then it goes better. Because you rub it again and it looks really visual. And when you rub it again, what happens is as you rub it, it turns into a little smiley face. So it's
right,
like...
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, I can see.
Kids magicians, maybe.
But then...
Strolling kids.
Then you rub it again... And it ends up with a smiley face this big, so it's almost like a jumbo coin thing to
finish.
So
you get, am I right in saying you get like a DVD with all the
moves
explained?
You get a DVD,
you get the gimmicks.
You get these, you get another two gimmicks, which I'm not going to say because it's going to expose the thing, but you get two gimmicks.
Is the coin gimmick?
There's
gimmick.
A coin gimmick included.
Right. Is that American or English?
You can get it in English or American.
Right.
You
okay.
can get it,
but that's included.
That's included.
The coin gimmick.
Yeah. The coin gimmick's
these
included.
Badges.
These are included as well.
Right.
And you get another gimmick as well, which allows you to do it. And it's almost instant repeatable if you're going out and doing
it.
Walk
it's not
around,
the sort of thing I do, to be honest with you. It's a bit small.
It is a bit.
You got to
tiny,
think,
but you know.
You just wanted me to look at it, didn't you?
Yeah.
I wouldn't give that a very high mark. That's not my sort of thing. If I was going to like mark that, you know, and I had actually watched a bit of the DVD, I'd probably say, you know, probably 69% for that. I wouldn't use that.
I know you don't work in the sort of places where this would be
yeah,
appropriate.
Yeah.
I mean, it might be a nice one to throw in sort of after while the judges are talking to you, but probably not. But I can see this working really, really well.
Right.
For somebody who does a lot of family restaurants.
Yeah, yeah.
And you walk up and you borrow a coin and you like you say, with children, I think it would work really well. And they're just not going to see that coming. And he's got on there Smilers Junior, which is like an impromptu version as well, which is really, really nice. It's not
so it's
the
like,
best
it's kind
thing
of like
in the
coin
world.
Coin magic for kids, maybe. But
yeah.
I don't know. What would you do? How would you rate that?
I think it's a nice version of the Spellbound plot.
Yeah.
I think that there's other stuff that Michael Rubenstein has done that's better, like the New York Coin Magic Project DVDs.
Yeah.
I think they're a lot better. But if you're looking for a nice, simple visual thing, maybe somebody who doesn't do much coin magic that wants to get into it, this is probably a nice place to start. As I say, you probably either love it or hate it. My advice would be to watch the trailer, and if they like the effect, go for it. You're not going to go far wrong. But I'd probably give it 80%.
Really, that high?
Yeah, See, I know what you mean, because I don't think it's for anybody, but I think that some people are going to make it a feature of their act.
Okay.
I think 80%. I think it's decent. It's not the best, but I think it's decent.
All right. Okay.
And you know, Michael Rubenstein's great.
80%,
I think.
Absolutely brilliant. Well, there you go.
Yeah. So you know, thanks for sticking around. I've got to go now. I'm really busy, but I'll catch you later on, Dave. You take care. All right. Have fun. See you later.
Where are you going?
I've got to go.
Hi, Karen. Yeah, I know. I got delayed. I'm really sorry. I'm coming, boss. I'm coming, boss.